Today I'm in coastal Santa Cruz Mountains. And when I say coastal, I mean coastal. Like, you know, the ocean is right there. And I'm looking for garter snakes. All right, so I was walking up this trail here, going around, and there's just this garter snake chilling here. It was having a tough time getting up, and that's why I was able to grab it in time. Not really sure what the species is. Bottom has sort of a blue, blue tint. And then, yeah, that nice dorsal stripe of yellow, as well as the red checkering with the black. Very nice snake. And I don't go west very often, so I've only seen these like a couple times before. Here's the habitat. See, there's quite a bit of poison oak. I have some poison oak rashes too from the other day. Gonna release this guy now. Go ahead. Little red-sided garter snake. Small little guy. Colors are not as nice as this one, but still nice to have found a snake in a little concrete pile here. Rocks aren't natural, and neither are the plants. That's an ice plant from South Africa. But yeah, nice snake. Put it away now. Go ahead, little guy. Ah, wrong way. There you go. Another little garter snake. And this one is lacking any and all red. Just blue, black, and that yellow dorsal stripe. I've seen adults like this. You know, like aquatic garter snakes and whatnot. And all three of the garter snakes that I've seen today have been rolling around like this. I've never seen them do this before, but pretty cool. All right, buddy, in you go. All right, I'm pretty much done with this area. I've moved to the beach and I'm now looking for legless lizards. Shouldn't be too tough. I was here not too long ago and I found a few, so hopefully I can find at least one. Oh, yep, nice. California legless lizard, the one I was looking for. Here's the legless lizard again. And to my knowledge, this is an adult, like full grown, and they don't get much larger than this, if at all. And one thing you'll see with these oftentimes is the tail will be missing and there'll be like a black knob. The scales that sort of heel over are entirely black. It's a bit strange looking. And I guess these, as opposed to a lot of other, you know, skinks and whatnot, even though these are not skinks, they're from a different family. They'll regrow tails, but these ones do not, if I'm not mistaken. The head is shaped like a wedge, so that it can be able to burrow in sand. And these will spend the majority of their life just buried down in the sand. And sometimes, during warmer nights, they will come up above the surface. And I guess since they have eyes, that may be the purpose of having those. Because otherwise, underneath in the sand, I don't quite see why that would be useful. But these guys are out here eating things like beetle larvae and whatnot. There's a lot of globose dune beetles and tenebrated beetles. And those are soft-bodied insects when they're in their larval stage, which is easy for these guys to eat. Is very well adapted for the sand. While it's not, you know, very quick by any means, I'll show you it digging in a second here. It tends to disappear quite quickly. And all the scales on its body are fused so that nothing can get really in between. And one last thing before I put this individual back in the sand to show you how it digs. This is actually a subspecies of the northern California legless lizard and yellow pulchra. This subspecies is Pulchra nigra. Since I want to show you a digging now, and might I mention, kind of a strange piece of cover to have found it under, considering I've been through many logs in the past hour or so. But anyway, I'm going to flip this back over. Now, let this guy dig down. You'll see it disappears quite quickly. And makes itself completely hidden. Like, we cannot tell that there was a lizard here, ever. Anyway, let this one go now. Huh, tiger moth caterpillars under here. The one right here. There's also a few down here. These guys are pretty funny. Not very interesting looking caterpillars, but the moths are actually quite nice. So I guess these guys are getting ready for pupation here pretty soon. Looks like a couple of them already did. I don't recommend holding these if you have very sensitive skin. Some people can get rashes. Yeah. Anyway, there's a couple more down there too. You see, down underneath the log. Try to not crush them when I put it back. So I decided to take them all out so that none of them would get hurt. And man, is there no shortage of these caterpillars here. Yeah, quite a few. They're all becoming active now. Oh, I just got shat on. Oh boy. All right, y'all can go back. And if you're wondering how they feel, the one left there, it's kind of strange. They're a combination of soft and spiny at the same time. It's very weird. Oh, a mouse. What are you doing here? Okay, this guy's kind of confused. I'm gonna try to put this back without harming him or her. I can't though, come on, leave. What are you doing? Come on, buddy. Oh, that's far enough. Go back. Good in there? Nice. Oh, lizard just slipped down. Yep. Another legless lizard. Nice. And here we go. This is the knob I was speaking about earlier. So it's not going to regrow its tail. And surprisingly enough, this specimen right here, being my fifth ever specimen, is actually the first one I've ever found that didn't have its tail still. This is the first time I've seen the knob, the black knob. Now, let me get a close-up of the head. Here's this little guy's head up close. I'm trying to make it too shaky here. There it is. You can see his tongue out there too. And you can see that the top jaw, if you will, goes over the bottom one slightly. That also helps or aids in avoiding sand from entering the mouth. They have very, very, very small nostrils. And yeah, you can see those scales I was talking about that are all fused. And those eyelids, you can see his eyes were just closed. Very effective in also keeping sand out. All right, I'm about to put this guy back. And generally what I like to do before I put them back is put a little bit of sand back around the edges. It keeps the sand underneath the log moist for longer. Now I can take this guy, put him back, and have no issues. All right, let's see if I can find another one. Yo, another mouse. What is this, a stingray? No, I can't say that I've ever seen a dead stingray before. But yeah, I think that is indeed a stingray. Vertebral column that would ordinarily lead to, you know, the stinger or the barb. Oh, come back here. Third lizard. Awesome. And this one is also has a complete tail, hasn't lost it yet. And this one is quite light in color, almost looks like a pulchra. Interesting, not very dark at all. This is the first one I've found under a proper, like, you know, log that's laying down, as opposed to those roots and the stump. Now, while I'm in this spot specifically, it's important to note that these only live in areas where the native plants are sort of, you know, the stronghold. Because in areas where there's a majority ice plant, which is a succulent that grows in loamy, sandy soils, in those areas, these guys can't actually live because the roots make it not suitable for their burrowing. I'll show you an area just a few hundred feet away from here that's dominated by ice plant to show you what I mean. And just a show of how close we are to the ocean. Not very far at all. That line right there where the plants stop growing is where the salt water doesn't really reach, or not often at least, and that's where these guys stop. They also live up in here. The sand is still very, you know, suitable for them, but there's nothing really to flip, so they're quite tough to find. And this habitat up here is very, very sensitive, so it's a terrible idea to be walking around in. All right, I'm gonna put this one back. Go ahead. Oh, another mouse. Oh. Hello, little guy. Wow. This is a small lizard. This is the first sort of, I guess, juvenile, if you will. This is the first juvenile Aniela I've ever seen. That's pretty cool. And I guess if they're small, they don't have very dark coloration, because this one is very much silver with a very defined dorsal stripe there. Since these things stress pretty easily and this one's quite small, I guess I'll just go ahead and put it back now. Go ahead. Oh, more mice. They're everywhere here. What's up, buddy? Oh, tail right there. Come here. Nice. Another legless lizard. Very cool. It's very, very dark dorsally, and ventrally very yellow. This is what they usually look like, actually. Not sure why I saw so many light specimens today. This is kind of the norm here. An archetypal Pulchra nigra. All right, I'm gonna let this individual go. Oh, yo, nah, I'm not messing with that. Don't wanna get hantavirus, you know what I mean? More of these guys under this log. More over here. Oh, that's interesting. This is a southern coastal trapdoor spider. I guess it just came out of there. I've never seen them, I've never flipped one before. This is a first for me. Interesting. Must have been, I don't know. It was somehow taken out of its burrow. My best bet is that the burrow has collapsed after someone stepped on it. I'm gonna let this guy go back under the log now. Go ahead. Hopefully it makes another burrow. I think it will. That was also the northernmost sort of, I guess, extent of that trapdoor spider's range. I'm literally a few hundred feet away from the northernmost single point that you could possibly find one. This is the infamous ice plant I was talking about. You can see all the natural vegetation here, native, and there's a line of it just creeping in. There's quite a bit of it, and the Aniela can't live here, as well as quite a few other things. Anyway, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.